Defining a toxic person will be different for everyone, but there seems to be a lot of toxic people in Hollywood because I have another part 2 list of the top 10 most toxic celebrities. Let me know who'd be on your list. Welcome back to Top 10 Beyond the Screen. I gotta say, happy Halloween. It is officially Halloween. We have been doing Halloween all week. As you can see, I'm a very sad Pikachu whose tail won't stand up. Let me know what you guys are being for Halloween and what you're doing to celebrate, seeing as we can't do very much right now. And to catch more of our videos, click the playlist right over here. But for now, let's get to this list. Starting off our countdown at number 10 is Chris D'Elia. He was accused with some serious allegations, and why people find him so toxic is because he's gotten away with them. Earlier this year, he was caught messaging an underage girl trying to make plans with her to fly to New York to visit him. He claims he didn't know that she was underage, but she said her Instagram profile shows her age. He walked away from the situation hands clean, and it seemed like people just completely forgot about it. Fast forward to September, he was once again under a microscope after 2 more women came forward and accused him of exposing himself to them. Both women claim he exposed himself without their consent and performed sexual acts on himself. Chris's lawyer made a statement saying that Chris denies these allegations and states that he has never engaged in any sexual conduct with any woman without her consent. Again, these new allegations came in September and people have already stopped talking about it, which is clearly very toxic. And I don't understand. I don't get it. Up next, number 9 is Offset. He has been making a lot of negative headlines recently after it was announced that Cardi B had filed for divorce since he was caught cheating on her again. So some would say that a person who continues to cheat on his wife is a toxic person, but if that's not enough reason, his most recent news headline might be. The rapper was questioned by police while on Instagram Live last week while he was driving through a Trump rally. The cops said they received reports that he was waving a gun outside of the car window. He refused to get out of his car after they asked, so eventually the cops removed him, and at that point the live stream was stopped. Later on, the Beverly Hills Police Department tweeted a statement that clarified Cardi B's cousin, Marcelo Almanzar, who was in the passenger seat of Offset's car, was the one arrested for carrying a concealed weapon and carrying a loaded firearm in public. So it wasn't actually Offset with the gun, but he was still there and letting it happen. You know, still not a good situation. Rolling into spot number 8 is Britney Spears. The only reason she would ever be considered toxic right now is simply because the situation she is in is very confusing. It's hard to understand what exactly she is going through because the media has led fans to believe a few different outcomes. A movement was started online called Free Britney after people were worried that she was being held under strict restrictions from her father, who has full control over her life and finances. She started posting these strange videos and photos on her social media, and people said that she was using codes in her videos to ask for help. But then her sister made a statement online saying that mental illness is not a joke and that she is not being held captive or harmed. All we know is the legal battle Britney is facing against her father as her lawyer tries to get her back her rights to her own life and finances. Her dad was granted conservatorship in 2008 when Britney had her breakdown, but now they want to get everything back in her control. Cruising into spot number 7 is Mama June. It's honestly hard to consider her a celebrity, but she did reach heights of fame that no one really expected for her time on TLC's show Here Comes Honey Boo Boo. She was the mom in the reality show, and her personality won over the hearts of many people. But all of her fame and success came crashing down after news broke in 2014, saying that she was dating a 53-year-old sex offender who allegedly assaulted her own daughter, who actually came forward with these claims. TLC immediately canceled the show, and people turned against Mama June, who continued dating him despite the claims from her own daughter. But she eventually moved on to another man, and that is when things got even worse. She was arrested with her new man in March 2019 at an Alabama gas station after police were called for a domestic disturbance. She ended up getting charged with felony possession of a controlled substance and drug paraphernalia and domestic violence/harassment. There's a lot of toxic things in that paragraph that I just read. Making her way into number number six is Shannon Doherty. In the 90s, you would have seen her everywhere. She was taking on lead roles in Beverly Hills 90210 and Charmed. Stories surfaced saying that she was fired from Charmed after an ongoing feud that she had with her co-star, Alyssa Milano. But that was never confirmed. All we know is that she left the show because of the feud, which was heavily documented for years. Fast forward to 2019, she reprised her role for the 90210 reboot, but got fired after getting into a physical altercation with her co-star Jenny Garth. So I see a pattern happening here. It's clear that she does not get along with people, or that there just has to be some kind of miscommunication and coincidence. But once things got physical, she was fired from the show immediately because she was the one who started it, apparently. Only 1 month after the incident, she was involved in another court case where she was accused of owing the bank around $36,000. So there's a few reasons why people might be skeptical about hiring her or even being friends with her. This girl throws down if she don't like you. Halfway through the list at number five is Ellen DeGeneres. 2020 has not been Ellen's year, and that is because she was attacked online all summer for allegedly not being as nice as she is on TV and having a toxic work environment. These claims started to surface after former employees and bodyguards came forward stating that the workplace was very toxic. But they only came forward after one of Ellen's guests, Nikki Tutorials, shared her experience on the show and said it wasn't what she thought it would be. She revealed that Ellen didn't even say hi to her before the show and that the overall experience wasn't as positive as she expected. The claims got so serious that her show was under investigation and two producers were fired from her show after they were accused of sexual harassment and misconduct. But Ellen's show somehow made it through and she's filming a new season right now despite everything. In her opening season 18 monologue, she issued a public apology and said that they were working on making their work environment a better place. Rolling into number four is Chris Pratt. The Guardians of the Galaxy star has been facing tons of backlash after one tweet started trending where people had to choose which Chris was the worst one. Amy Berg tweeted, "One has to go," and attached pictures of Chris Hemsworth, Chris Pratt, Chris Evans, and Chris Pine. The innocent joke turned serious real quick after Ellen Page called him out for supporting a religious organization that reportedly discriminates against the LGBTQ community. The organization is called Hillsong Church, and in 2015, the senior pastor wrote in a post that the church welcomes all people, but does not affirm all lifestyles, including the gay lifestyle. Their words, not mine. And to top it all off, people exposed the fact that he might be a Trump supporter. He did not attend the recent virtual fundraiser for Joe Biden, which was attended by all his other Avenger co-stars. Though he hasn't openly said that he discriminates against the LGBTQ community or that he supports Trump, people are claiming he is more toxic than people realized and that he's just quiet about it. And the third spot is Shia LaBeouf. There was a time when he was one of the biggest actors in Hollywood and didn't get involved in drama or controversy. But then that all changed and he was the center of it. Things seemed to take a dark turn for the actor in 2017 when video footage showed him wildly drunk and yelling racial slurs towards police officers who were arresting him. It was a hard scandal for him to defend because it wasn't just a story that he could deny. The whole thing was caught on camera and we got to see exactly what happened. After the incident, he was sentenced to 10 weeks of court-ordered rehab where he says that he learned that his violence and defensiveness was a result of post-traumatic stress disorder coming from an incident in his childhood. After that, he did have more controversial moments in his career, but he seems to be in a better place more recently. He was blacklisted for a while in Hollywood though, with one director saying that he is too much of a liability to hire him. AKA, he is too toxic. Moving on to number two, we have Bill Cosby. Luckily, this toxic celebrity can no longer be spreading his toxins across Hollywood because his behavior had him locked behind bars. If you followed his highly publicized trial, then you would understand why he is considered one of the most toxic celebrities in Hollywood. His career came crashing down in 2014 when allegations surfaced that he had sexually assaulted more than 50 people throughout the years 1965 to 2008. After one woman came forward, it was a domino effect and other women came forward with their stories. Bill always claimed his innocence and battled the different allegations for years. But in 2018, he was found guilty for 3 counts of aggravated assault and then he was sentenced to 3 to 10 years in state prison. Now, that doesn't seem like a long time, if you ask me, like not enough time for his crimes, but since he's 83 years old right now, some people believe it's basically the rest of his life in there. Coming into our number one place is Chris Brown. People were wondering why Chris Brown wasn't included in the big who is the worst Chris debate. Because out of all the other Chris celebrities in the category, he is definitely the worst one, or should at least be considered. It seems like the world forgot the night in 2009 when he left his then girlfriend Rihanna bruised and bleeding. Now, he later admitted that their relationship was toxic and that the physical abuse was on both ends, but most people will agree that there is never an excuse to hit a woman. Chris did an interview after the altercation and fully admitted to punching her in the face that night, admitting that he felt like a monster after it happened. He was arrested after the photos and news stories broke the internet, and Rihanna actually testified against him in court. Some people were more forgiving towards him and saw it as a toxic relationship, while others saw his behavior as personal anger issues and very toxic violent habits. All right guys, that is our part two list. Let me know what you're thinking down in the comments, and also don't forget to tell me what you are being and doing for Halloween. But for now, I'm gonna end this video with some comments from top 10 Hollywood celebrities who mysteriously disappeared. Naya Life says, nice outfit, I haven't seen Sleeping Beauty in so long. Well, that is because I was not Sleeping Beauty at all. I was actually Snow White, but thank you. Darwin Ang says, just out of curiosity, what color are Lucy's eyes? You can't see her eyes. Her eyes are like the most blue eyes I've ever seen in my entire life. If you find her on social media, it's literally like you can't miss them. Geek Artist Fanboy says, you are Snow White. Question for you, who are your seven dwarfs? Well, I actually only have Landon, who was grumpy, and Jared, who was sleepy. So I need five more. Taking applications. Megan McKenzie says, I'm so happy for Cameron Diaz. I bet she makes an awesome mom. I bet she makes the best mom. Imagine your mom was Cameron Diaz. That'd be so freaking cool. No offense to my mom. All right guys, that is all I got. I am getting out of here. I hope you guys all have the greatest Halloween possible during these COVID times. Leave a like, it really helps us out. I was your host, Joss. I will see you next time.